So my name is Takashi Inui, the professor of Graduate School of Agriculture. Today I'd like to give you a lecture on drug delivery system, DDS, by using intravital transporter protein. The title of my lecture is Development of Innovative Drug Delivery System by Highly Biocompatible Proteins. So this figure shows the mortality rate per 100,000 people for each major cause of death in Japan, announced by Ministry of Health, Labor, and Welfare. So as you can see, in recent years, cancer diseases has a higher mortality rate of increase than other diseases, such as strokes and heart diseases. So cancer is a serious disease with a growing number of patients, not only in Japan, but also worldwide. So the major treatment of cancers are surgery and radiotherapy as a topical treatment, and chemotherapy as a systemic and metastatic treatment. So here I would like to focus on the chemotherapy for cancer diseases using anti-cancer drugs. And the advantage of cancer therapy is an excellent therapeutic effect on the whole body, but the disadvantage is a severe side effect. So to reduce this disadvantage, it is necessary to develop a drug delivery system, DDS. So what is a DDS? DDS is an ultimate drug discovery system and the technology to specifically deliver the required amount of drug to the target tissues or cells at the appropriate time. As a result, the excellent DDS enhances the medicinal effect and also eliminates a side effect. So this is the three major technologies of DDS for delivering drug to the affected area accurately. The first is the drug solubilization technology that improves the drug absorption in our body. The second is a tissue or a cell targeting technology to perform the target-specific drug delivery. And last is a controlled drug release in target cells. And the DDS possessing these three major technologies is considered to be an excellent DDS. And excellent DDS will contribute to the less side effect, enhancement of medicinal efficacy, a reduction of medicinal expenses, and also reduction of new drug development risk. And that's contribute to the treatment of intractable cancers, such as brain tumors and pancreatic cancers. So in this study, we use the Lipocalin-Type Prostaglandin D Synthase, namely L-PGDS, as a drug delivery vehicle. So at first, this protein was found as an enzyme, and L-PGDS catalyzed the isomerization of prostaglandin H2 to prostaglandin D2. And prostaglandin D2 acts as a neuromodulator in the central nervous system, where it induces sleep. On the other hand, this protein is a transporter protein for hydrophobic ligands, small ligands, such as heme metabolites, thyroid hormones, and retinoids. With a dissociation constant, KD values of 30 nanomolar to 2 micromolar. So we call this property as a broad ligand selectivity. And in addition, LPGDS has also loss scavenger, reactive oxygen species scavenger, and shows a protection against the loss-induced neuronal cell death by scavenging the reactive oxygen through the thiol of cysteine 65, like this. And on the other hand, this protein was expressed in the mammalian central nervous system, such as choroid plexus, leptomeninges, and oligodendrocyte, and secreted into the cerebrospinal fluid, CSF, with a concentration of 10 micrograms per milliliter. That's the second major protein in the CSF. And we also reported that L-PGDS was quickly eliminated from blood to urine with a T-half of 46 minutes in K9. And based on these functions of L-PGDS, we focused on its functions as a transporter protein, and then attempted to apply L-PGDS as a drug delivery vehicle. This is the structure of L-PGDS determined by NMR. So left here shows the side view, and right here shows the top view of L-PGDS. And as you can see, this protein has an 8-stranded antiparallel beta barrel, and also the central hydrophobic cavity here. So in this cavity, L-PGDS can bind the hydrophobic, that is, poorly water-soluble drugs, such as SN38. So in this study, we use SN38, 7-acyl-10 hydroxy camptothecin, as an anti-cancer drug that inhibits the DNA topoisomerase 1. So in spite of its potent anti-tumor activity, SN38 was not used clinically because of its poor water solubility. So then, CPT-11, that is irinotecan hydrochloride, and the water-soluble prodrug of SN38 was developed and used in clinically used. And especially for the patient with advanced colorectal cancers. However, the anti-tumor activity is of CPT-11 was below 1% of SN38 and shows a severe diarrhea as a side effect. So thus, direct use of SN38 is a great advantage for the cancer treatment. So first, we check the solubility of SN38 with or without LPGDS. The concentration of SN38 in PBS was only 1.5 micromolar. But in the presence of 2 millimolar LPGDS, the concentration of SN38 dramatically increased up to 1,700 micromolar, showing 1,100-fold solubility improvement. And this is the concept of tumor-targeting protein capsules. So first, CRGDK, that is a tumor cell-targeting peptide, was introduced into the C-terminal of LPGDS by using the genetic recombination technologies. And this CRGDK recognized a neurofilin 1 receptor that is expressed on the surface of cancer cells, resulting in the internalization of whole protein capsule into the cancer cells. And the capsule incorporated into the cancer cell released the encapsulated SN38 by cleaving the endogenous disulfide bond in response to the intercellular reducing environment. And then SN38 exerts its medicinal activities. So to validate this concept of DDS, we tried to make protein capsules. This is the design of the protein capsule encapsulating SN38. So first, we performed a docking simulation of LPGDS and SN38 by using a docking program, autodock beta, and predicted the amino acid residues involved in the binding of SN38. So as you can see, since multiple aromatic amino acid residues were considered to be involved in the binding of SN38, so we replaced the methionine 94 on this strand with tryptophan, that is bulky and hydrophobic amino acid. So this protein was named M94. This protein capsule was named M94W. And finally, we make the M94W CRGDK protein capsule that was created by adding the CRGDK. This is tumor cell targeting peptide into the C-terminal of M94W. And this was named by M94W CRGDK capsules. By using these capsules, first we check the uptake of protein capsules labeling enhanced green fluorescence protein, EGFP, into cancer cells. These cells are human prostate cancer, PC3 cells. And the blue color indicates the nucleus of cancer cell. As you can see, neither EGFP nor EGFP labeled L-PGDS was taken up into the cancer cell like this. There are no green fluorescence here. However, the capsules with CRGDK was taken up into the cancer cells like this, these green fluorescence. That was demonstrated by the confocal fluorescence microscopy. And next, we check the controlled release of SN38 from the protein capsules. First, the binding affinity of SN38 to the LPGS or M94Ws. By using the tryptophan fluorescence quenching assay, as you can see, the M94W was found to have a about twofold higher binding affinity than LPGDS. And this here shows the release rate of SN38 against the time by using the equilibrium dialysis method. So LPGDS showed a spontaneous release of 100% of encapsulated SN38 at 48 hours, this black line. However, M94W suppressed the spontaneous release of SN38 to 47%. And in the reducing environment with 10 millimolar DTT, remaining 50% of SN38 was released. So from these results, we demonstrated that our protein capsule possesses three major technologies, such as drug solubilization technologies and cancer targeting technologies, and also the controlled drug release technologies. So we shift to the in vivo evaluation of anti-tumor activities. First, PC3, human prostate cancer cells, were implanted into the right flank of male nude mouse. And that when the tumor volume was reached to 250 cubic millimeters, each sample, such as PBS, SN38 LPGDS, SN38 M94W, SN38 M94W CRGDK was administered intravenously every 4 days for a total of 4 times. The tumor volume was calculated by these equations. And the total volume, and tumor volume and body weight were measured for the following 30 days. So these here show the anti-tumor activity and the change in the body weight. And the horizontal axis represent the number of days after the administration of each samples. So as you can see, in case of PBS administration, the tumor volume was increased in the day-dependent manner. However, in case of SN38 LPGDS administration, the tumor growth was somewhat suppressed. And in case of SN38 M94W administration, the tumor growth was significantly suppressed compared to the SN38 LPGDS administration. But the body weight was quickly, rapidly decreased and reached to the 80% of the initial body weight. So the experiment was stopped due to the regulation of animal experiment ethics. However, in the case of SN38 M94W CRGDK treatment administrations, the tumor growth was completely suppressed, at least during the drug administrations. and also changes in the body weight was almost equal to that of PBS administration. So these results suggest that the SN38 administration with our protein capsule suppress the side effect of body weight loss induced by SN38. So we have successfully created protein capsules possessing these three technologies. So our next challenge and our next step is a clinical application. So as this study shows, DDS study is a multidisciplinary research, and thus requires the knowledge of a wide range of disciplines. So gather, talented students, so let's enjoy science together at OMU. That's all. Thank you very much.